Hey, what's up, guys? David Glenn back for DavidGlennRecording.com, ThePRoAudioFiles.com, and my new site, TheMixAcademy.com. In this tutorial, I want to kind of show you a few things. It's going to be one of the rare ones that is Pro Tool specific. Some things that I do to get the technical process out of the way a little bit when I'm dealing with plugins, parameters, keyboard shortcuts, just a few little things that I threw together that I thought you might find useful. You may know all of them, you may not know any of them, you may know one or two, but I think this will be valuable to some people out there. So one of the first things I got on my list is setting a default EQ and compressor. And you can do that by going to Setup, Preferences, and you'll see if you click through these tabs up at the top, go to Mixing, you have the option to set a default EQ and a default dynamic section. I recently purchased Virtual Mix Rack from Slate Digital, and there are both compressors and equalizers in that rack. So that's a no-brainer for me to have as my default dynamics. I get the best of both worlds, but then I also am a big fan of the FabFilter Pro Q2. This could be anything for you guys, but pick the one that you're going to use the most and put those into those slots there. Where does that go? Well, if you go to instantiate a plugin, now those two plugins are going to be right there. Your default EQ on top, your default compression or dynamics processor right there. And it's just a click of a button away. Pretty sweet way to working with tracks. Now, I highly recommend using templates. And I'll maybe do a course I'll do a tutorial on how I set up my template and the different processes that I go through to keep it organized and my thought process. I've got a paid course over at DavidGlennRecording.com called the Mix Series, where I go all throughout that, but probably worth noting how I set that up and do different things within the template. But moving on from that, we've also got what's next on the list, adding a favorite plugin, even beyond maybe you don't want to put, for me, like the UAD Studer. That's not going to be my default favorite plugin for what we just showed you right here, but that is something that I want to easily access instead of going down and going to dynamics and scrolling through UAD, all the plugins and all this stuff. I don't want to do that. And you know, you go into the manufacturer, that makes it a little bit easier, but that takes too much time. So what I'm doing is I'm holding command and I'm going to click to instantiate a plugin. I'm going to go find the one that I want. In this case, we talked about the Studer. Let's go get the Studer. Scroll down here, S, da, da, da. And there we go. So you'll see UAD Studer A800. You're going to let it, you're going to click it. This has already been done for me, but if you click it, it's going to then place it at the top of your plugin list. And so now you see this list of plugins up top. That's where it's going to be. And then you're going to look, it's going to be in alphabetical order. And UAD Studer right there. Now it's important to note, you have to do this for both mono and stereo instances of the plugs. If I had a mono track, I would have to do the exact same process so that it ends up in this list up here. You can see, I actually don't even think I have the Studer, so I can show you. Go Universal Audio, go down to S, let's find it, Studer, mono, there we go. So you'll see it didn't activate the plugin and didn't instantiate it. But when I click and go here, now it's going to be right there, added to the list, and I can pull it up a lot quicker and kind of get the process of hunting for that plugin out of the way a little bit. What's next on the list? We've got setting the user default. So for me, let's pull open the Studer, because a big thing for me is a lot of these plugins add noise. And you'll see that right there. By activating this plugin, it's got the noise on. Well, if I want to instantiate that plugin and not have the noise, I can click, turn it off. Sure, I could do that every time. Who wants to do that? So instead, I'm going to come up here and I'm going to save this as, we'll call it, I'm going to save for me, David Glenn Recording, I say DGR default. Cool. Now I've saved that default. Well, then if I launch it, I could go select that preset. Who wants to do that? I don't. So let's go here to this little ticker there next to preset, and let's go down to set as user default. When I click that option, now when I launch that plugin, it's going to default to my preset, and I have that noise turned off. And you got to make sure you go to setting preferences, set plugin default to user setting, not factory setting. You got to make sure it's set to user setting. So let's deactivate this plugin, add it back, and you'll see this time when it launches, the noise is off and my default preset is dialed in. pretty sweet there. What was on the list here? We've got the holding command. Okay. So a lot of you may know this one. A lot of this stuff is going to be maybe sort of basic, but I think it's important. So let's pull open my favorite EQ at the moment. It's the FabFilter Pro Q2. And I'm going to show you. So this, again, I've got my standard default setting for this is to have a low cut high pass filter instantiated, and it's right there. I can click and drag, and I have a whole process where I go through. And that's one of the first steps I do with EQ is just to remove the stuff that I don't need from the lows of whatever the track is that I'm working on. So that's there. I can click and get to work. I don't have to double click and then get to go, you know, not that big of a deal, but every little step adds up, accumulates to a more efficient workflow and saves you time. So with this particular EQ, what I want to show you is let's go ahead and maximize it. If you're on Mac, you hold Command. If you're on PC, you would hold Control. And you can, so let's say I'm working with this frequency here and I'm dragging it, whatever. Well, if I hold Command and do that, it's going to, actually, we're going to go to a parameter here. If I hold Command, it's going to slow down or help you to do more subtle changes. So it's going to help you to be a little bit more smooth, a little bit more in control of what you're working with. And that's pretty much for all parameters in Pro Tools, you're going to be able to do that. So if I'm swiping through, I use a trackpad, so I use two fingers and swipe up and down. I can actually shift through this like so, or I can hold Command, and at that same speed, I'm much more restricted in the amount of gain or how quickly I'm moving across that parameter. So that's a sweet feature. Another one you can see here, if I'm boosting and then I can hold Command and tighten and make the bell wider. If I'm working with gain, I can make it nice and smooth, or I can throw it like crazy. So something to note about using Command when you're working with parameters, that can be helpful for volume faders as well. You can see I open this up and click with my mouse and it's all over the place. That's a little bit of a pain in the butt. So what I will do is I'll click, kind of get it to where I want it, and then I'll hold Command, and now it's moving in much smaller increments. It's a little bit more, it's easier to control it that way. So I'm using that a lot. If you're not using a control surface, then this would be a great tip for you if you haven't used that before. Moving on from that, we've got activating automation lanes. This one is huge for me. If I want to activate, let's say that I've got a, let's say what can be a good thing. Let's say we've got a, this is a two track on here. This is a mastered stereo file. Let's say I wanted to boost a little bit at 1K at just the chorus. I can instantiate this and then go to the power here. Hold all three modifier keys. So if you're on Mac, it's Command, Option, and Control. If you're on PC, it's going to be Control, the Windows key, and what's the other one for you guys? Option, I think it is, or Alt, whatever that one is, Alt. And you're going to hold all three of those, and this is going to come open whenever you click on a parameter, and you can enable that automate for automation. Now, that's going to be automatable. I'm going to close it. You go over here to Waveform, goes down to the FabFilter Pro Q2, and you'll see that Band 2 state, the power on and off, the master bypass for that band is, I'm able to pull that up and I'm able to see the automation lane. I can make a selection and I can enable it or disable it. So now you'll see it's shaded out, it's disabled. If I undo that, it's enabled. Cool. Now here's one step further for that. You can see this track, I hit my minus key and snap back to my waveform view. If I wanted to, let's say I made a selection and I wanted to apply it to this, well, I can hit hold Command, Control, and then click on the power button, and it's going to snap to that automation lane. So it saves you a ton of time when you're going to automate. If you know you want to automate, let's say the game, three modifier keys, enable it, Command, Control, and then now that automation lane represents the game. You can see it snapped to it. I didn't even have to blink. Just becomes second nature to you. And it works really, really well. So the cue, let's say we wanted to automate the cue, same thing, all three modifier keys, Command, Control, click, it snaps to that lane and you can get to work. So I hope that those help you. Just a few things that I use on a day-to-day basis that really help me to be more efficient. And ultimately, you're more efficient, you save more time, you're making more money because it's gonna help you get your mixes done faster. So get your head out of the way, get your ears working for you. Hopefully that helps. DavidGlynnRecording.com, ThePRoAudioFiles.com. Go check out TheMixAcademy.com. Just $27 a month. You're going to see me mix start to finish. I'm going to record the entire process. Exclusive tutorials. We got a private community forum. Mix critique. All kinds of stuff going on in there. That's just blowing my mind how great the guys are inside of there. Helping each other out. I'm chiming in as well, of course. And all great stuff to come from that. So themixacademy.com. Like, subscribe, show your support. We love you for it. We appreciate your help. And it helps us to continue to bring you more videos. So we will check you guys out on the next video. Thanks, guys.